Percussion. My name is Andrew Paulson, Minister of Music here at St. John's. On behalf of all of us, welcome. Thank you. Thank you for coming. What a crowd. This is so exciting. I am honored today to be joined by Dr. John Pennington, who's a prolific musician, educator, composer, performer. I got to know Dr. Pennington through my time at Augustana University in Sioux Falls, where he was my mentor and teacher, and now friend. He now resides in Portland, Oregon, as the executive producer of OCP, Oregon Catholic Press, and you can read more about him in his bio. This is a program that we have performed. We performed in the Midwest, and have performed together for many, many years. This is our first time on the East Coast performing together, so thank you for being part of our East Coast debut. I do want to take a moment to flip to the back of your program to look at the patrons of the 2021-2022 St. John's Artist Series. Their support makes events like this happen, to bring in Dr. Pennington, to bring in different artists throughout the year. So thank you, patrons, for your support. And we still have one more concert in 2 weeks coming up, so there is still time if you would like to be a patron. You can see the levels below. And if you would like to give a donation and are not ready to become a patron, there are baskets at the doors as well. In 2 weeks, be sure to come back the afternoon of Palm Sunday for a presentation of Michael John Trott's Seven Last Words, a wonderful way to continue your Holy Week journey. That's all for now. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you. hospital. Good afternoon, rather, excuse me. It is a joy and a delight to be here in Lansdale, Pennsylvania. I told Andrew my mother's maiden name was Lansdale, so I think I am among my people. I think I'm home. It is a delight to be here at your beautiful, beautiful church and with Andrew. As an educator, as a teacher, as a performer, it's absolutely just the best job in the world to see these people at the burgeoning, the inception of their careers, and to see them and to follow through with his lovely wife, Rachel, as well. This concert is something that we performed. It centers, for me anyway, on this sort of the vibraphone. It is kind of an American invention. Its genesis is maybe around 1916. It's the most similar really to the piano. Maybe that's the thing that I like about it. It has a lot of the same capacities. Although I play with four vowels, and of course the pianist has 10 digits. So the piece we just played was the first movement of the concerto by Emmanuel Cicernet. He's a great friend of mine. He teaches and works and lives in Strasbourg, France. He's a great friend. He wrote me a piece years ago for a true percussion and choir that I've played many times over at Jim's. The next piece that we'd like to do, actually, are three pieces, a suite, if you will. Moonchild, the aria, Bach's aria from the Goldberg Variations, and the number suite. I guess if I went backwards, so the Respighi is just a piece, a piano piece that I had just never heard until just a few years ago, and I was just captivated by the magic of it, this piece of the night. The second piece, the aria, is one that I'm just so enamored with. It is the aria. It is the piece from which Bach produces 30 additional variations. We're playing the aria. And it occurred to me reading a specific text in which the author suggests that there's a Count Cagerin who actually commissions Bach for these for the Goldberg variations. And particularly he suffers from insomnia. And so it is said that he actually has this young student, Goldberg, actually play them at night as he retires and just go to sleep. I just love that image of having someone play this music as you go to sleep. It's a couple of things. Goldberg apparently was 14 years old at the time of this, at the time when this would have been handed to Cagerin. And also, if you listen to the whole 30 variations, it's not exactly sleep time music for most of it. But the aria by Cagerin, again, it sustains that magic and inventiveness. And then we'll begin with a jazz piece by Keith, the jazz pianist Keith Jarrett, Moonchild. So Moonchild, aria from Bach's Goldberg Variations, and Nocturne by Percussion.
Thank you.
this is like 1973-ish, and he wrote them over a series, a number of years. And I think the proposition was, what would it sound like to try to what does a young child to capture the imagination of a young child, the awe and wonder and laughter and excitement of a child? What does that sound like? And it seems to me that through these movements, and there's dozens of them actually. We just selected them, actually the first seven, right, the sequence. But there's just a range of character and emotion that is quite fun. They're quite short, so we'll go almost the talk off from one to the next. But this is Chicory's children's songs. I am enamored. I think we are enamored with. I'm sometimes doubling the piano. And so he has all the work, which in many ways is what I always strive for. My career is somebody else do a lot more work than I'm doing. But it is that quality of us, as opposed to him, the piano accompanying me, we are playing things together. And the combination of the timbre is, to me, the magic. So this kind of, I guess, is a part of it. These are Chicory's. Thank you.
program. So it's very hard to have a concert here in this gorgeous space with this gorgeous organ and not do a piece on the organ. So in trying to find a piece, I came across this wonderful toccata that maybe you've heard me play as a closely before here at St. John. But this is John Rutter, known of course for his choral composition, who does have some organ works, and this is his toccata in 7.
Just what a young percussionist kind of learns and instinctively kind of imitates. So all of those kind of sounds are made that are coming to play here. This is Bill Douglas's vocal aid. Some some kind of a transition, and I will move to a drum from Azerbaijan. And I know all of this must sound just cacophonous to you, but it feels like musically, it feels like a musical hurricane. But to me, in the middle of it, it's quiet. And it's just like in the middle of that, where there's chaos all around, but it's beautiful inside of it. But a lot of my research has been on what you're about to see. A lot of my personal research has been in French drumming and music and instruments from other traditions. So all of that said, more explanation.
Thank you.